Good morning. How y'all doing? Hey y'all, we're gonna do Dirty Laundry Monday, but you guys gotta get me to 3,000 likes, okay? Grand Rising, Tisha, good morning. How are you guys doing today? For all the people who have subscribed in the last 3 weeks, I will be sending out a message to you guys. And if you have subscribed in the last 3 weeks, please email me. If you became a subscriber in the last 3 weeks, please email me. Good morning. Hey, Sophia. All right, guys, how y'all doing this morning? Good morning, good morning, good afternoon in Portugal. I cannot wait to visit you in Portugal. Okay, I love Portugal. I've never been, but I've researched the country. It's so beautiful. And I can't wait to get over there. We're going to start with the tarot. Hey, hey. We did have an amazing resurrection day. Thank you. We just really did self-care and taking care of ourselves and the house and, you know, just enjoying each other and resting. Sometimes it's okay to just rest and not do something, you know? Y'all don't pay attention to my nails. I need to get them done. They're growing. And I need to get them done. If you need a reading, the link is in the bio. I'm not doing free card pulls today, okay? I usually only do those on a Friday, and I don't do them that often, honestly. Hello, hello. Thank you for sharing my live. But we're gonna get into this reading, y'all. My readings, they're price-based. The link is in the bio. Rich Rising, Kiki, how are you? Thank you for sharing my live. Come into this reading, spirit, for this collective. Y'all ready? Let's put our jazz on. My window is up, so y'all gonna be hearing lawnmowers and them blow things and all that other shit, because it's going to be a nice day here. People are trying to get on top of their yard work. What do I need to see, please, spirit, for this collective, for this Dirty Laundry Monday? I'm good. Hey, Tracelle. How you doing? How you doing, Tricelle? It's been a while. Hello, Dipsy. If you need a reading, the link is in the bio, okay? 100, 105. Is, wow, I just saw 100. Now it's 105, 108. Good morning, good morning. Thank you for the follows. I know that's right. Shimala, I need to see, please, Spirit, for this collective, for this Dirty Laundry Monday. What is the message? What do I need to see about this collective here, please? Hello, hello. Good morning. Good afternoon. Good evening, wherever you are. Bottom of the deck is the Ten of Pentacles. That's some good energy at the Ten of Pentacles. Could be talking about family. Could be talking about your money situation. I feel like you're moving to calmer waters with someone. Maybe you've been in your feelings a little bit about someone, or someone's been in their feelings about you. Okay, but they coming towards you. But with the King of Wands energy, I feel like someone wants to move to calmer waters with you. Could be an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, an Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit. Wow, okay. For this collective. What do I need to see? What do I need to see? We got the Justice card, the Queen of Cups, the Seven of Swords in the reverse, and the Star. There's some type of justice. Make seven, and then we got seven out here again. So seven, seven, seven. Okay. And then we got Queen of Swords and the Hangman in the reverse. Bottom of the deck is the King of Pentacles in the reverse. I feel like so there is a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn that finally gets sent about some type of a hard ending. I feel like there could be someone trying to do black magic on you. I feel like this person got clarity about, or they got clarity about someone doing black magic on them. Oh. Someone got clarity of someone doing black magic on them. Could be a baby's mother or someone that lied about being a baby's mother. Someone could have had a miscarriage recently. Could be a Virgo, Taurus, or a Libra. And I feel like someone's trying to get over that, but someone's really in their head and something is done, like a relationship is dead, done, over. We're going to clarify these. Someone really wants to come together with you, okay? This is what I'm feeling. There's a lot going on in the background. And whatever this is that's coming in towards you is justice. It's a wish fulfillment, okay, that's coming in. I don't know if this is some type of a letter or if this is actual communication from a person in person, okay? But someone is either bored with their options and they want to reconcile with you. With the Seven of Cups here, I definitely feel like they have other options, okay? But they want to come back towards you. I don't know why. We got the Queen of Swords, and you're like, your back is to all of this. I feel like this person has a lot of love for you, you know, in a way. But I feel like you're done. Like your back is toward the cups. I feel like you're focused on you. You're focused on your spiritual path. You're focused on healing. All right. I'm going to use my queer tarot to clarify these. Show me what I need to see, please, sir. For the justice. You dreamed about black snake, black and red snakes last night. Wow. Capricorn. So what is this, Spirit? Can you clarify these cards for me? Thank you for the follows. Bottom of the deck is the Nine of Cups. I definitely feel like, I feel like someone's guarding their happiness. We got the Nine of Wands, the Nine of Cups. So you could be seeing 999. You could be seeing 777. Okay. Also 555. I do. I feel like you're making a decision to guard your happiness here. There's something that you're holding on to, though, that you need to let go of. It could be emotionally. I feel like you are trying to come out of, I feel like you're trying to come out of some type of a depression or some type of a sadness or something like this here. You could be a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, or a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. I feel like you won't let anyone ever do that to you again, is what I'm hearing. Like, I won't ever let anyone put me in this space again. I definitely feel like you're going after your own happiness and money. I feel like you're making some type of a decision about growing your money. That's, yeah, we are in a collective, so I don't know who that's for, but. All right, let's see what comes out here. What is this justice? Thank you. We got the Death. So there's some type of a big transformation happening, and this is justice, okay? The ending of something and the beginning of something else. There's some type of a transformation. We got the Nine of Cups peeking out back there and the Queen of Cups. Definitely lots of emotion going on here. We got the Queen of Cups already out here in a different deck, okay? Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio energy. Pisces with the Nine of Cups again. What are y'all saying? Relocated to Portugal from Germany, and my son wanted to stay there. Hard to let go. Aw, yeah, I bet. I feel like I might have that decision very soon, too. To move somewhere without someone that I thought would, you know, be with me. But, you know, times change, you know. What is wrong with the notifications? I don't know. They got me shadow banned. So if I don't send it out to you, you won't get the notification. Some of you do get the notifications and some of you don't. They got me shadow banned. They're even taking away my views. Like, at the end of my lives, I can always see my views and my likes, and they're taking away a chunk of them every time I do a live. They're just haters. What is this Queen of Cups? The justice. Now, I can't fucking make it up. There's some justice coming in here to you. We got the justice in two different decks. Something that had to end, needed to end. But you're going through some type of a transformation now. So whatever is coming into you, Queen of Cups, this is meant for you, okay? And you don't have to be a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio for you to be a Queen of Cups. You could just be a mother, or you could just be someone who's really caring and compassionate, okay? You could have Pisces in your chart. You could have Libra, Scorpio, okay? But not necessarily. What is this Seven of Swords in the reverse? What's the Seven of Swords? Why is the Seven of Swords? The Lovers. So this is going to be something you can trust here. Nine of Pentacles and Eight of Cups. You could be walking away from being single. You could be walking away from being single. Maybe that what this justice is with the Lovers here. The Seven of Swords in the reverse. It's something you can trust. This is meant for you. I feel like this is either a soulmate or this is a twin flame. Okay. It could also be a contract. So if you're not looking for love or something like this here, there's something that's coming in here for you. Something that you're going to be very compassionate about. Something that is a wish fulfillment. And also something that is going to be very healing. Okay, I got the chills. What is this star? I can't make it up. It's something brand new. The Fool. Aries energy. The Lovers is Gemini energy. This is a brand new beginning. This justice is coming in for you, okay? Something is ending, totally. And there's something new coming in here for you, and it's total justice for you. I love it. Thank you for the follows and the shares. In a relationship now, been 7 months. True facts. I'm reading a collective. What is this Four of Cups? We got the Knight of Pentacles. Oh, there's another card. And oh, and the Knight of Cups. You might have a decision to make. Someone's coming in slowly and someone's coming in fast. Okay? And I feel like someone's not so sure that you're going to accept their offer or something like this here. You could be dealing with a Virgo, Taurus, or a Capricorn, or a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Someone, there could be two totally different types coming towards you. Like, one is bald and looking sexy on that horse, and then this one has like a dad body and got a full beard and mustache and all that. So there could be different types coming towards you. Someone could be a hood rat, and someone could be, you know, very conservative, very intelligent, have their shit together. So I guess it's going to be up to you to decide what do you want. Or you can decide to be single with the Nine of Pentacles on the bottom of the deck. I don't want neither one. Yes, this is a collective. Thank you, Nikki, for putting that up there. It says right there, you guys, that this is a collective. You're laughing your ass off at hood rat. Oh, Lord. You know, sometimes, let me say this. Sometimes it's our wants that get us in trouble. So I just saw a young lady put up there, I don't want this and I don't want that. Let me tell you something. God has already have your person picked for you. And they may not be the usual type that you would go for. Everything that look good ain't good for you. That's including food. Okay? Places. Things. Okay? So we need to be a little bit more open-minded and stop trying to control what spirit brings in and out of our lives. Understand that every person you meet is for you to learn from. They're a teacher. Everybody you encounter. Okay? So there could be someone that spirit brings towards you that isn't your type, but your souls are so connected. And I'm speaking from experience. Okay? And when you have a soul connection, that person is absolutely beautiful to you and is exactly what you're looking for. So don't be closed-minded. What is this Three of Cups? What's this Three of Cups? We got the High Priestess coming out. I feel like you already know that this is coming together. Look, Four of Cups again. We got the Four of Cups down here. It's just repeating everything, y'all. Yeah, food can look good, but it not be good for you. Y'all know that. Y'all know that. Look at all the damn fast food restaurants. Is that food good for you? It might look good, but is it good for you? Happy Monday to you. Thank you so much. There's no reason to think that someone, you know, someone might not be your type, okay? But you are going to be attracted to them in such a way, and you're not going to understand it. You're not going to understand, why am I so attracted to this person? Like, this is not that you, it's because you're attracted to their mind, their body, their soul, okay? Their body comes later. Like, you know, sometimes we have to learn how to grow up. What is this Seven of Cups? We got the Sun and the Eight of Pentacles here. If you need a reading, the link is in the bio. keep freezing. There's nothing I can do about that. Maybe you should go in and come out or something like that. Uh-oh. People muting, folks. I don't know what happened, but thank you. Well, thank you for coming in. I appreciate that. No, you don't have to settle. You don't have to settle for anything. You don't have to settle for anything. But all I'm saying is, if you keep being closed-minded, you may never find your person. You could be just being too picky. No one's going to be perfect, and no one's going to check off all your boxes. However, there are people that are meant to be together, that can grow together, that can learn together. I'm just giving you a fair warning, just so you don't end up keep looking. And especially since if you're a woman, you're not supposed to really be looking like you're supposed to be attracting. Why is this Eight of Swords, this Queen of Swords here? We got the Queen of Wands coming out for the Queen of Swords. Okay, there could be some type of a business deal here. One of these deals that's coming in towards you could be some type of a business deal. And I feel like it's going to be multiple with the Seven of Cups here. It's going to be multiple. Or job opportunities. But definitely some people want to come back together with you. I feel like you have a lot of people in your energy that's about to want to come back towards you. Some people are new and some people are old. Remember I said Mercury retrograde is coming at the, look, we got 999. Something's definitely ending. Nine of Wands, Nine of Cups, Nine of Pentacles on the bottom of the deck. Something is definitely ending. And I feel like it has something to do with either you being alone or not being able to get the right opportunities coming for your business or your money. I could read this both ways, okay? Because these could be contracts, new contracts. And it could be a something that you're interested in that you're very passionate about. Okay, but whatever's coming in here is justice for you. This is not a bad reading at all. This is an amazing reading. It could be love and it could be money coming in towards you. And I'm not talking about little chump change. I'm not talking about your tax return, okay? I'm talking about money. Something that's going to make you really, really, really stable, okay? What is this hangman? We got the Two of Cups. Love is coming in. Contracts are coming in. We got the Lovers and the Two of Cups out here. Contracts could be coming in. There's also love coming in. And I really feel like it's soulmate energy. Or a twin flame. And none of these are bad cards. These are amazing cards out here. I feel lots of creativity happening with y'all. I feel like your third eye is opening up to do what you want to do on your life path here. I feel like some of you guys are about to start or venture on a new relationship or something like this here. Well, you have plenty of options, okay? Coming in towards you. We got the King of Pentacles on the bottom of the deck. So we have the Knight of Pentacles, the Knight of Cups, the Queen of Cups, and the King of Pentacles, and the Queen of Swords, and the Queen of Wands. There's lots of people involved in some type of a situation here when it comes to work that I think are bringing together some type of work for you. I don't know if this is community. You could be really big in the spiritual community with this High Priestess here. And maybe that's you bringing in people through your spirituality. What y'all saying? Oh, wow. Thank you, Latasha, for the confirmation. It looks like your last three readings. Who did you get your reading from? New, fresh. Absolutely. Gratitude is absolutely, as soon as you open up your motherfucking eyes in the morning, your gratitude should be off the chart. Okay. You know, I live in a neighborhood where, I live in Baltimore City, Maryland. And there's always a lot of shoot that night, even in the neighborhood and it's not an ugly neighborhood or any of that, but there's always some shooting, and it's just crazy because you just never know, you know. You walk outside and then you hear the helicopters, you hear the sirens right after it, and it's always in the middle of the night, and it's like not far from my home because I can hear it pop, 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 pop. It's like, this is what we're doing? So it's just be grateful to get up in the morning, because every day, you know, people are losing their lives for senseless shit. Okay. All right. I do want to clarify the major arcana on here, and I'm going to do it with the other deck. And then I'm going to move on to my cards so I can see what the fuck's going on with y'all for this Dirty Laundry Monday, okay? If you pay for a reading, I will do your reading when I'm done with my collective. If you're new here, thank you for your support. Thank you for coming in. But when I'm done with my collective is when I look at the readings, okay? I don't like to interrupt the energy. All right, clarify these cards for me. There's a lot of major arcana out here, which tells me that this is major things that's happening with you guys. Like starting new love, starting new businesses, moving forward on your path, something that you're compassionate about, okay? You're going to get justice in this. The justice coming out twice, like, all right, spirit. Bottom of the deck is the Hierophant. We got the High Priestess out here. All right. What is this death? Why is this death here? We got the Hermit. There's a lot of transformation happening here. Lots of wisdom being gained. Lots of inner introspection being done by you guys. You could be a Virgo, or you could be dealing with a Virgo, or a Libra, or a Scorpio. Look, Ace of Cups. I can't make it up. There's a love offer coming in. It's definitely going to lead to a higher commitment with the Hierophant on the bottom of the deck. And the Ace of Cups. Why is this Two of Cups here? What's this Two of Cups? We got the Empress coming out. So there's some type of a connection here, or some type of a contract here that is very, very fruitful for you. If you're not pregnant, or if you're not planning on having a baby or anything like this, this could be a contract with it clarifying this Two of Cups that is something that's very, very fruitful for you. And it's going to be a new beginning here. It's a wish fulfillment. Whatever this is, it's a wish for you that you've asked for and that you're about to get. I got the chills so bad right now. What is this Fool? Why is the Fool here? Oh, we got the Knight of Cups again. Someone coming in to romance you. Different decks. Okay, someone, you wish for this. Someone coming in to be all nice, loving, and romantic. You got a few people coming in hurt. Okay? But someone really wants to sweep you off your feet. There's that Nine of Pentacles on the bottom of the deck, though. So you're going to have this choice. You could be very guarded against it. But we got the Sun here. Someone sees that you're guarded as fuck. I feel like somebody wants to come in with some type of an apology. Someone who can't seem to let go of something, and they seem like they're going through some type of karma here, okay? But they're watching you, and they're seeing that you're guarded as fuck. And they're like, oh, okay. Yeah, I feel like you're guarding your freedom. You're guarding your happiness. You're guarding for what you're reaching for. You're like, nope, this is what I'm focused on this time. This is what I'm doing right now, okay? If you want me, you come to me. Show me. That's what I'm feeling, okay? It's like, show me. All right, we're going to separate this Knight of Pentacles and this Knight of Cups and clarify them, because this is two different people here. And we already got another Knight of Cups out here, okay? You could be dealing with a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, or an Aries. Also, Virgo, Taurus, or a Libra. What is this Knight of Pentacles doing here? The Eight of Cups. So you could be walking away from this Knight of Pentacles here that's coming in towards you. Yeah, look, this Fool. I'm just getting the same card, you guys. New beginning. You're walking away from whoever this is that's moving slow as fuck. Okay. Watch my mouth. What is this Knight of Cups? The Ace of Pentacles. Now, this the one, baby. They coming in with it. I said, you walking away from that Knight of Pentacles, a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn here. But your wish is coming in. Now, this Knight of Cups is showing up with the real deal here. They got the ring. They coming with the ring. They not, you know, moving slow and thinking about it 15 times and I don't know, but this Knight of Cups is coming in with it. Look, fools on the, they're like, are you gonna take this trust fall with me or what? Are you gonna do this with me or what? Okay. Why is this High Priestess here? She's not into I and I. What the fuck is I and I? Waiting for the Magician to show up. Only one missing so far. Okay. How y'all doing? KK. What is KK? What is I and I? Okay. I don't know what that means. What is this High Priestess doing here? We got the Three of Wands coming out. I don't feel like you're, like, it came out in the reverse, so I don't feel like you're, like, waiting for this to happen. I feel like you're anticipating that it's going to happen. Like, you already know that it's coming. Why is the Sun here? You could have tattoos on your legs. Why is it? Some of you could surf. The Seven of Pentacles, the Seven of Cups, the Seven of Pentacles. We keep getting 777. And then we had 555 and 999. So you guys could be seeing those synchronistic numbers, okay? Somebody wants to put the work in here. Somebody wants to put the work in here. Could be a fire sign. Could be a Virgo, Taurus, or a Capricorn. Why is this Eight of Pentacles here? I was just going to do the major, but... Why is this Eight of Pentacles here? Damn, the High Priestess. Again, different day. I feel like you already know about this work too. Like it's something about your work. I feel like it's gonna make you travel too with the world here. There's something about your work. There's something that you're working on that's gonna bring you in some good money. And it's something passionate. It's like a project or something like this here. I don't know if you do work on the web, on the World Wide Web, okay? But this is a new cycle starting for you. And it's like, you know it's coming. You know it's coming with work, with anything. I feel like you're doing a 180. Like, you're like, everything is changing. What are y'all saying? Nikki, be nice. You do content creation. Nice. Thank you. All right. So let's see what the Lovers is. And then we're going to close it out. I'm going to pull my cards and we'll get... I've never done a Dirty Laundry Monday this deep in. But Spirit is letting me know that I'm doing the right thing. So what is this Lovers? I guess you guys needed this. There's definitely contracts coming towards you guys. The Lovers is the Four of Wands. There's a marriage happening here. There's some type of a marriage that's going to happen here, okay? With the Lovers and the Four of Wands, the Two of Cups and the Empress, like someone has found their Empress, and they're coming in with this offer, whoever this Knight of Cups is, okay? They don't have to be a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, because we got all the signs out here. All we really don't have, we have Aquarius, Libra, Gemini with the Queen of Swords. That's the only sword. So it's like someone is no longer in their head about this. There's a lot of wands here, so they're ready to put in the action. Lots of energy when it comes to love. Like, I feel like this person's heart space is really full for you. Okay, whoever this Knight of Cups is that's bringing in this, they know what they want to do. They're ready to move forward here. This is definitely a higher level commitment. Okay. Okay, so let's get my cards out. We're going to do my cards and then see what's going on with y'all for Dirty Laundry Monday with my cards. And then we will look and see if anyone wanted a reading. Give me a second, you guys. All right, so we're going to start with our favorite deck, which is the Violet Flames deck. Thank you for the follows, you guys. Virgo marrying a Taurus. I'm finally ready after she asked 4 times. Wow. You're lucky that person asked you 4 times. Some people only get it once, and then that's it. I hope that you're happy, though. Wayne is on board. Hi, Wayne. I didn't know that that you announced yourself when you came in here. That's interesting. This resonates. I know that's right. You're welcome. Let's see what comes out in my cards, y'all. It's happening in behind the scenes in y'all lives in the Dirty Laundry Monday. Let's see, okay? 404 in South Africa. Hey, South Africa. Thank you for joining. Bottom of the deck is shark. So Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio energy. What else? Could also be a business shark. We got polyamorous coming out and unhappily married. Oh, so someone's sleeping around because they're unhappily married. They're in a polyamorous relationship, but they're unhappily married. We got left me hanging. What else? I see the karmic is watching you and unhappily married and doesn't really like men. So the karmic could be married to your person and they're unhappily married and they don't really like men. We got I regret running from this and voice. Also, the karmic is watching you. We got any curses have been lifted and panda also 411. So there could be some type of intellectual conversation that you're getting ready to have with some type of exchange with someone. Bottom of the deck is kicked out. Whoa. So somebody could have got kicked out over the weekend. We got telling you lies and throwing shade. Oh, and Fox. Also distance and a broke ass. We got so many tears. So somebody, and eating better. So somebody is crying over, I feel like someone is crying over something that has spilled milk, is what I'm hearing. We got kicked out. So somebody got kicked out, okay? We got, my past holds me back from you in so many tears. So someone's crying over you. Superiority complex. If you're new here, we got Eating Better coming out. If you're new here, Spirit deals with me in colors on the different cards that I have that I've made. So the story starts to unfold with me and Spirit talks to me while I'm putting these cards out. So be patient, okay? What else? We got relocation. So some of y'all could be moving with this Eating Better and relocation. You could be getting ready to relocate and maybe your money's going up, okay? And you're eating better. We got left me hanging. Somebody's upset. We got my past holds me back from you and broke ass. Also Fox. Somebody trying to be slick about something? What else do I need to see for this collective? We got Panda and talking shit. So there could be someone that you look up to that you thought was wise or something like this that talks shit about you. We got VIP pass on the bottom of the deck. What else? We got overachiever and voice. There's something about your voice. We got backfired and unhinged. So someone tried to come at you wrong? And that shit backfired? What else? We got sex worker coming out. What else? Superiority complex and dating with a purpose. So there could be a sex worker who only dates certain types of people. Because they have a superiority complex, like they're picky or something like this. Here, we got so many tears and lap dance. We also got, I just want to stop thinking about it. Oh, wow. So somebody wants to stop thinking about it because it makes them cry. Whatever they're thinking about here, it'll come out. We got polyamorous coming out and uninterested. So you could be uninterested in this person and they want to stop thinking about it. They want to stop crying about it. They want to stop. They see you eating better, but you're uninterested in them. We got soul tie. What's this? What else, spirit? We got sex worker in 411. So someone could have got some information on someone being a sex worker. We got mission in motion in Kundalini Awakening. So some of y'all could be going through a Kundalini Awakening, and I feel like you're on your life purpose. You're on your path. Kundalini Awakening just came out. Some of y'all are on your life path. So you're uninterested in this person that just can't stop thinking about something because you're moving on your path, okay? We got someone likes your body. Oh. And relocation, also taking a long time to reply. So, okay, someone likes your body. This is some type of a soul tie. They could have tried to get you into a polyamorous relationship or something like this here. Or maybe you're in one. We got taking a long time to reply, and they want your gifts. Also rejected. What's this? We got trouble in paradise. So someone is having trouble in their home, and they want to stop thinking about it. Maybe they made the wrong choice or something like this here. But you're uninterested. You're eating better and you're going through some type of an awakening here. We got rejected. What else? What are y'all saying? 10. What else? Wow, 244 in here as I look up. We got instant karma coming out and unbothered. So you're unbothered by this person, uninterested, but someone has trouble in their home. We got inconsistent in tunnel vision. So there's something that you want to go for, but you're inconsistent in it. Like you're trying to go towards something, but you're inconsistent in it. You need to have tunnel vision. Focus on that. We got 411 coming out. Broke ass keep on showing this. I don't know who's broke, but somebody's losing money or something. And we got alter ego and keep smiling. So someone has an alter ego. We got gossip. Someone could be talking about you. Could be a soul tie. They're getting instant karma maybe for talking about you or trying to bring you into some type of a polyamorous relationship here. We got moves in silence and snake. Wow. Moves in silence and snake. So someone's being sneaky, like I said, when I saw that fox. And now we got snake out here. And look behind snake is spell work. Wow. What else? We got wolf. And doesn't really like women. So someone doesn't really like women, but they act like they do. And we got Holy Grail code and moves in silence. So there's something about your spiritual path that you're not telling people about. Okay? And we got broke ass and 411. So you're going to get some information about somebody who don't have money and they might ask you for some. We got dating with a purpose and unhappily married. Oh, so someone is married, but they're dating people? Okay. We got wolf jumping out. So you're a wolf and we got a snake. There is, whoever this snake is, they're having trouble in paradise and they're crying over you. What else? Nine needs space. So maybe this person told you at some point in time, or maybe they need space from whoever they're having this trouble in paradise with, whoever they're unhappily married with. Wolf could mean something to you, but I'm feeling like you're a lone wolf. Like you're a lone wolf and you don't mind that. We got, why did you choose me? So someone has low self-esteem, or I don't know. Someone has low self-esteem. We got alter ego in marriage. So maybe someone's alter ego came out during a marriage. We got snake. What else? We got surprise and having sex for money. Well, we did say there was a sex worker, okay?
Okay.
By bottom of the deck is I regret running from this. So whoever's in this marriage that they having trouble in paradise, they regret running from you. And maybe they told you that they needed space. Okay? Maybe they were acting uninterested, but now they crying over you. Anyway, so we got this back door. And good at fucking, bad at love, and likes to be licked. Wow, this, somebody is really, really, whoever this soul tie is, they really want to try to get you into some type of a polyamorous relationship. I feel like this person is just, they're not good at love. We got surprise. We've been getting that. We got drama starter coming out here in feathers. So you could be getting some type of messages with this surprise and feathers here. Some type of unexpected messages. We got sleeping with the enemy. And elder abuse. Someone abuses their parent. Someone's abusive to their parent. We got someone wants revenge and sleeping on the couch. So someone wants revenge because maybe they think someone else messed up their relationship. Someone's about to find out something that's going to shock them. Somebody's going to find out something that's going to shock them. It's going to be something that you're not expecting at all. It could be someone trying to get you into a polyamorous relationship. And you may not know it. Give me a few more. Give me a few more, spirit. We got a mattress back. I'm telling you, someone's a sex worker studying your weaknesses and never let you go. Wow. So someone's trying to study you to figure out how to come in the back door to get you. Or they could also like to have sex, anal sex, with this mattress back here. But someone's studying you because they want to try to create some type of a soul tie with you. They want revenge. But you're going to find out something that's going to shock you. About someone. What y'all saying? What's a polyamorous relationship? More than one lover. Like somebody wants to just be able to sleep with whoever. They want to be the only man or female. And they want to have their per people, you know, with them. R. Kelly. Anybody. I mean, there's a lot of people out there that do these type of polyamorous relationships, okay? They're not just with one person. I mean, I feel like that's okay as long as you let other people know that that's what you have going on. But, I mean, you can't, don't make that decision for someone else, but someone ain't letting you go. Whoever this is that keeps crying, that they're in a marriage that they don't want to be in. They are a drama starter, but you're unbothered, and they're a snake. I feel like you're a lone wolf, and you are unbothered. You're going through a kundalini awakening, and you're eating better. You're doing good. So I would leave it at that. But someone's trying to figure out a back way into your energy to get you stuck in some type of polyamorous relationship. Okay. So be careful of that, because that just is, that's wild. All right, we're going to do one more deck, and then I'm going to look and see who paid for a reading, you guys. Show me what I need to see for this collective. What are y'all saying? Cake and eat it too. This is more common now. Yeah, it is. What else? What else do I need to see? We got trauma bonding. What did I say? Somebody studying your weaknesses. Somebody trying to create a soul tie with you because they want to bring you into some type of relationship or something like this. We got speak that truth, Stacy, on the bottom of the deck. So I guess I am speaking that truth. Okay, Spirit. Let's see what comes out, y'all. We got musicians. So one of y'all or some of y'all can be musicians or something like that. We got false promises coming out and authentic and trolls and back off. So if you got some trolls, they need to back off or something like this here. We got to speak that truth, Stacey. Ooh, I got the chills. What else? We got big. So something's happening that's going to be huge is what I'm hearing. Really, Spirit? I'm sorry, but the way the huge came across to me sounded like the cheddar cheese man. Y'all all know who I'm talking about. We got humble brag coming out here. Yeah, there's something big coming in here that you're going to be able to humble brag about. Or maybe you will humble brag about. Something big. See, a humble brag just flipped over. I'm taking it. And we got bright clothes. Uh-oh, so y'all could be going shopping? Y'all could have been doing some shopping? Oh my God, we got to speak the truth, Stacey, in a different color. I can't make it up. I will never send you confusion. So Spirit is reminding you that I would never send you confusion. So if something is making you feel confused, it's probably not for you. I'm more affected than you know. So someone is more affected by your actions than you know. We got cheater, could be a cheater. It's the same color. And decision. So yeah, there's a decision you made to cut someone off because they cheated. And they're affected more than you know. They were a cheater. But they got, this isn't over. So someone feels like it ain't over. And we got emotional roller coaster. And I'm more affected than you know. I can't fucking make it up. There's some type of a decision that you made that sent someone to an emotional roller coaster. And they're more affected than you know. We got authentic again and unique. So someone thinks that you're authentic and unique. These guys also got health problems in them too, guys. So they may come out. Speak that truth, Stacey. And divinely orchestrated. No, that's too much, Spirit. All right, we got, I look you up online to see what you're up to. Like I said, somebody watches you. I'm going to take this. I speak to you through songs coming out, and I just saw chills. So maybe you give this person the chills. Maybe you make them nervous. We got to spend time with Spirit in meditation every day. And gold digger, also gamble. So someone, and family. So someone likes to gamble their family money away. Maybe they don't pay their bills right or something like this here. Bottom of the deck is 10. So something's ending, something's beginning. We got, this isn't over. So someone really feels like it isn't over. And I'm not waiting for you to recognize who I am and renewal. So some of you guys could have left this person, you know, in the dust. Okay. You weren't waiting for them to recognize you. But you're starting some type of transformation here, like rebirth or something. We got cheater coming out. Also fast in the morning sometimes. So Spirit wants you to fast in the morning sometimes. And we got trolls. And I underestimated you. So someone underestimated you. Maybe they thought you weren't going to walk away. We got, I'm more affected than you know. I can't make it up. Also, I speak to you through songs. So someone tries to speak to you through songs. And Spirit says build more muscle. Also baby fever. Oh, who got baby fever? And chills. Some of y'all could be getting over a sickness or something like this here. Oh, diabetes and chills. So maybe your sugar drops. Your sugar might drop and you start shaking. We also got getting in their feelings. Whoever this is that speaks to you through song that underestimated you, they be getting in their feelings about you. I'm going to just do a few more shuffles of this one, y'all. And then I'm going to see who paid for a reading. We got you owe me something. Oh, someone feels like you owe them something. Whoever this is that underestimated you, that speaks to you through songs and is getting in their feelings, They feel like you owe them something. No. We gotta look you up online to see what you're up to. Look at this creative outlet. I was talking about someone's creative outlet earlier. It could be online. Okay. We got a bank account. I'm trying to tell you. And heat. Somebody's bank account's about to go up because of their creative outlet. Whatever your creative outlet is. This is on the bottom of the deck. Creative outlet, heat, bank account. Your bank account's about to be on fire. Okay? I like that energy. What else? Oh, this is what came out. We got, if I'm impulsive and impatient, run. And snakes. Spirit is already telling you there's some snakes coming towards you that feel like you owe them something. Be careful. We got, I know you were trying to make me grow, but I wasn't ready. So whoever this was that looks you up online and speaks to you through songs and underestimated you, they knew you were trying to make them grow, but they wasn't ready for that shit. We got hidden feelings coming out here in Charlie horses. Ooh, somebody having Charlie horses?
You're getting over a sickness. Okay. Thank you for sharing my love. Wow, 317 in here as I look up. 310 now. My mama likes to gamble my money away. Oh. Blocked him on every health problems. The accuracy is scary. It's all spirit.
Why am I in your business? I ask spirit. Don't ask me. What else? Okay. We got denial coming out here and you owe me something. So somebody's in straight denial. Like someone's illusion has illusions. We got clap back. And we'll take that. That'll be it. Bottom of the deck is I'm not the same person you remember. So maybe this person's going to come in and try to make you feel like they're different now. They could be. Okay, but you know, we all can change if we put the work in. We got heart coming out here, so some of y'all could have some heart issues and diabetes. We got kids coming out. Also, I'm scared you won't like the real me. So this person never showed you the real them, and they're scared to show you the real them because maybe they're crazy. I mean, I don't know. But they're scared that you won't like the real them, okay? Don't let people cause confusion in your life. Yes, please don't do that, okay? We got scars. Someone has some type of a hidden feeling. Somebody's been scarred. Someone around you, maybe you said something or done something to them, or they did something to you, and they have some hidden feelings about it, okay? It's like a scar, a deep scar. We got pituitary gland coming out. And ask for bigger things of spirit. So y'all asking for small things instead of asking for what you really want. We got don't project your feelings onto others. And before that came out the kids. So don't project your feelings onto your kids, okay? If you guys are having, you know, issues at home, try to remember to breathe before you say something. We got I'm not letting you go that easy. Oh! And jail time. Oh, somebody could be in jail or they could be just in their head about you a lot. We got fear of commitment. So this person has a fear of commitment here, but they stay in their head about you. We got it's easy to stay away right now. That's the only one. Oh, no, it's not. I'm more affected than you know. They're more affected than you know, and they're saying it's easier for them to stay away from you right now. I don't know who this is in your energy. Could be a earth sign with this green here. Doesn't have to be. Okay, that's good. I hope that y'all enjoyed the Dirty Laundry Monday. I try to be on here between 9:30 every Monday Eastern Standard Time. All right, and well, I'm going to see who paid for a reading, and I'll do your readings, and then I'm going to get off of here. I'll probably be back this afternoon after I go for my 7. Because it's a beautiful day. I'm definitely going for my 7. Thank you for the follows. Wow, you guys. Thank you so much for the follows. All right, let's see who paid for a reading. And the list is open, you guys. I'll take six people. I do have some coaching to do today, you guys, so I don't know what time I will be on in the evening, but I have some coaching. I do spiritual coaching, so if you all are interested in that, you're welcome to take a look at the link in my bio and see what I offer. Ms. Dark Diamond, what is your first name? I love that email address. The link is in the bio. You're very welcome, Miss Serenity, and everybody else. You guys are so welcome. Yes, this was some dirty laundry. What did you say? Yes, this is some dirty laundry. You clean the fuck out. The link is in the bio. Oh, hey, Tashi. You didn't have to pay for another one. I owed you one from the last time. I emailed you. You never emailed me back, Tashi. You didn't have to pay for another one. It's almost like you know me. Aw. Spirit gives me a lot of messages, honey. Right, Tashi. You paid for one. I don't know if it was last week or something like this, and I emailed you. I emailed you to say, when can we do it? And you never responded to me. So now I see that you just sent me more, okay? So what do you, would you rather have a personal one-on-one with me since you've already basically paid for a full reading? Would you like to do that? Oh, thank you, Latasha. Oh, thank you for subscribing. I appreciate that. Please email me because I'm trying to get off of TikTok. Because they shadow banned me. And I can't DM you guys the information to get to the private group because they've blocked me. So please, please send me an email. If any of you guys are in here, you subscribed in the last 3 weeks, please send me an email so that I can get you the information to get to the private group, okay? Where and when, I'm gonna email you. We can do it today, Tashi. When you get off work. Or are you working?
Good morning, sunshine. My name is Frankie.
I have an email. And the link is in the bio. Thank you, Dawn. That's so sweet. Let me see, T. Welsh. Alright, let me see what this is. You guys, thank you for being patient. It takes time for the stupid stuff to come up. You guys know that. Wednesday or Thursday? That sounds good. I'll email you. Good morning, Taz. How are you today? Tracy, your payment did come through. Did you want general love, financial, health, or, I don't know, spiritual? Grand Rising, thank you for the gifts. Tracy? Yes, you missed the collective, baby. I'm posting this. It would be love. Can we do it private? Not for the $15. No. A private reading is $65. It's not time, you know, efficient for me to get off of here and do a, you know, 7-card spread for you. I can't do that. Sorry, that's just not. Grand Rising, X Stacy, how are you? Personal readings are $65 and I do schedule those. You can buy them in the link in my bio and I email you and I find out what date and time. This young lady, Tashi, she paid for one before. She had to leave. I didn't get a chance to talk to her. She just paid me again for another one. And it's adding up to a full reading. So you have to understand that I'm being, you know, I'm doing what I'm supposed to do as a businesswoman. For the $15, I do them here online. And that's exactly what that banner says. Okay. Yeah. We can do it right now. Okay, so you want love. Let me use my love oracle for you. And then I'll also, I'll pull a few of the tarot. Show me what I need to see for Tracy when it comes to love, please, spirit. Show me what I need to see and not what I want to see. We ask that you protect us while we receive these messages. And we thank you today, spirit. Show me what I need to see for Tracy for love. Bottom of the deck is not enough. So you could have been in a relationship where someone was making you really frustrated. Made you lack confidence or something like this here. Maybe they always made you feel like you were not enough or something like this here. Show me what I need to see for Tracy for love. So it's going to show me past stuff. It could also show me, you know, future stuff or stuff you're dealing with right now. That's why I'm going to pull a card or two from the tarot, okay? Show me what I need to see for Tracy for love. Yeah, there's a... Wow. There's a relationship that's dead, done, over. Wow. We got the runner chaser out here. We got heartbroken. So definitely feel like you're trying to heal from some type of a heartbreak here. We got the runner and the chaser. So this could have been a false twin flame. We got the coffin. So I definitely feel like that's the relationship that's over, that runner and chaser. Like one of y'all was running, one of y'all was chasing. I got the chills so bad. But you're about to receive, a heart with a key. I don't know if you have some type of vacation plan with this palm tree and paradise here and camera. You could be planning some type of vacation. You could also be getting ready to meet someone while you're on that vacation because we got heart with a key and talking. I don't know if you've already met this person or what. But someone's not showing their full hand. Like, someone's trying to figure out their options, but somebody kind of wants to take a chance on this, okay? Give me a few more for Tracy, for love. That was coming out fast. We got the Phoenix. So you could be rising from the ashes at this time. Maybe this relationship really took you out, okay? And we got the Snake. So you definitely were dealing with the Snake in the past, okay? Show me what I need to see for future energy for love. For Tracy, what's going on? Tracy for love. I always give my people, even though you only pay, you know, for a 7-card spread, guys, I always go into the story to see what else I can pull for y'all. So don't ever think you're going to get gypped by getting some type of a reading from me, okay? Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit, for Tracy when it comes to love. For future energy. We want to see future energy, please, Spirit. For love, for Tracy. Bottom of the deck is the Chariot. You're moving forward, honey, okay? Yeah, you're starting something new. You may be feeling out in the cold or left out in the cold right now, but with the Fool here, definitely feel like there's something starting new for you. Love for Tracy. Just give me a few. We got the Two of Swords. You're going to have some type of a decision to make when it comes to love. Yeah, because we got the Knight of Cups. Someone's coming in. Bottom of the deck is the Four of Cups. So someone feels like they missed out on some type of opportunity. You got, girl, you're going to have plenty of people coming towards you. We got the Seven of Cups and Knight of Cups. You're going to have a decision to make. There's going to be people trying to romance you here. But the Four of Pentacles, I feel like it's going to be something that you can hold on to. You could also be focusing on your money right now. Empress energy. Yes, Star energy. Oh, yeah, you're going to be fine, Tracy. Yeah, you got multiple people coming. You're going to have to make a decision, though. Someone actually is going to give you a heart. You're their heart. Someone is, okay? Heart with the key. You're going to be actually getting along with this person. Like, when you meet this person, you're going to really get along with this person. All right, Tracy. I hope that helped. All right, anybody else? Hello, good morning. If you would like a reading, hey, Stacy is my pet name. I am Aries. Your pet name? Okay. Actually, I spell my name with an EY. You guys, I think that was it. That's good. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your day. I will be back out. I don't think anyone else has wants a reading, Nikki, and that's okay. I got work to do. I'll see you guys sometime this evening after my coaching. You pay for one? What did you pay for one on? You too, ex Stacy. Oh, you did it on. Okay, I see it. I see it. I just needed to refresh. Natalie? Are you Natalie? Okay, Natalie. It says that, did you want general love? Yeah, I hate that it doesn't let you guys tell me what kind of reading you want. Oh, thank you, Tracy. You want love? Or do you want general or financial? General, okay. We're gonna use the Queer Tarot and I'll clarify. Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit, for Natalie. What do I need to see, please, Spirit, for Natalie? What can can I see, please, Spirit, for Natalie? What does Natalie need to see? Show me what I need to see and not what I want to see. We ask that you protect us while we receive these messages, and we thank you, Spirit. Looks like you're moving to calmer waters after having some people talking about you here, or people stabbing you in the back. Maybe some jealousy. Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit, for Natalie. You're moving to calmer waters. I feel like you're walking away towards your happiness, okay? With the Eight of Cups and the Six of Wands here, there's some type of victory here. Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit, for Natalie. Bottom of the deck is the Six of Wands. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy. The Wheel of Fortune. Something's turning in your favor. Wow, the Star. Okay. We got the World and the Emperor. I love this, Natalie. I feel like you are walking away from some bullshit or something. You're very guarding. You're so much guarding your new future here. Your new cycle. Like, you are standing up for yourself. You're walking away from things that no longer serve you. And I feel like you're taking control of your new future. Like, your new cycle. This is amazing. You got Six of Swords, the Seven of Wands, the Eight of Cups, the Emperor, the World, the Star, the Wheel of Fortune, and the Six of Wands. I don't know if you do something online that's going to actually put you out there, but I'm feeling like you could definitely be someone who has a lot of fame in the future if you don't already have it now. Like, I feel like it can come from you starting something online. Or you doing something online. But something is changing for you and you're about to have a victory. Aquarius energy, also Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, Taurus, Scorpio. Wow, you got the World and the Wheel. This is amazing energy. That's just the bottom of the deck. Show me what I need to see for Natalie. What do I need to see for Natalie? Show me what I need to see for Natalie. Wow. Bottom of the deck is the Chariot. You are moving forward. Cancer energy, Ace of Wands. There's some... Wow. Okay. Natalie, there's a commitment coming in here towards you. Oh, I think someone may have broken your heart in the past. Okay. And I feel like you're really taking a look at who you want to give your love to. But there is a twin, there's either a twin flame or a soulmate coming in here towards you. The Four of Wands, the Two of Pentacles, the Ace of Wands, and the Chariot. I definitely feel like there could have been someone who juggled you in the past, but I don't feel like this new person is going to do that at all. I was reading your energy in the collective. Right now. Okay. Good morning. Good morning. We got the Temperance coming out. So something's definitely bouncing out for you. We got the High Priestess. Oh, and the Magician. Oh my God. We got the Three of Pentacles coming out. The Hierophant. Oh my God. The Nine of Swords. The Seven of Swords. The Justice. The Hermit. You got a lot of major arcana here, girl. The King of Pentacles in the reverse and the Strength in the reverse. There could be someone around you who's losing money. Could be a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. There's some type of a coming together here. Ooh, I got the chills so bad. I feel like you know it's coming too. I feel like you know it's coming. Like you've been manifesting it. You've been manifesting this. And it's about to come together for you. With the Three of Pentacles. This could also be something with work. I do feel like you're going to be in your head about it. Or you have been in your head about this. But it's going to be all worth it. The Justice and the Hermit. There's a higher level of commitment here with this Hermit. The High Priestess. The High Priestess is right above the Hierophant. This is a very spiritual connection here. That's coming together for you. Okay. I feel like you really have been trying to manifest this in. And I feel like you have all the tools that you need to manifest this in. there's some type of higher awareness that you and this person are going to have together. I definitely feel like you're going to be in your head with it, because you're not going to believe it. But this is it. This is definitely it. And I feel like your money could be going up or something like this here. I don't know who this King of Pentacles is here in the reverse that came out with the Strength card, but I feel like this person is trying to make a way to come back towards you. But I feel like it's because they have money issues, okay? Could be a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn, or a Leo. Doesn't have to be. We got Sagittarius energy out here. Taurus, Virgo, Aries, Capricorn, and Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn, Pisces, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, Libra, very strong, and Virgo, very strong. Interesting. Very interesting. Let me give you a fortune cookie to see what the future holds for you. Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit, for Natalie. What's future energy for Natalie? What do we need to be made aware of for Natalie? Yep, see, I can't fucking make it up. We got bottom of the deck is wisdom. The Hierophant, the High Priestess, and the Hermit, there's going to be a lot of fucking wisdom here. A lot of wisdom, a lot of spirituality, a lot of growing, a lot of coming together and making shit happen, okay? Bottom of the deck, to focus on the past is to lose the future. Heed advice from an older person, me, okay? Which will allow you to move on. So if you're still stuck in your head a little bit about something that may have happened in the past, whoever this King of Pentacles in the reverse is, probably, let it go. Because what's coming into you is like a love that you'll never, ever, ever, ever get before. Okay? From before. We got surprise. A disappointment will be followed by a pleasant surprise. An invitation could bring love to those searching. And then we got travel. Long distance communication will open up your life. Exciting experiences for singles and career advancements for others. So you're going to be traveling. I think I said that you could be traveling. We got tough and trying times, and I feel like you've already been going through this. Tough and trying times ahead. Think long term and make decisions accordingly. Avoid negative people at all costs. Whoever that King of Pentacles is in the reverse. Okay? And then we got achievement. Enjoy the limelight. Like I said, you have like some type of a star quality. Like there's something about you that has a star quality, okay, Natalie? And I don't know if that's something on your road, on your path, but you have a star quality, okay? Enjoy the limelight. You've earned it. Although on the family front, someone's health could cause some secret worries and sleepless nights. So there could be someone getting ill in the family, or someone is ill and you might have to take care of them. We have personal riches. Small successes are likely now, and bigger ones are on the way. Your finances could improve dramatically, but avoid get-rich schemes. And we have manifestations. A bountiful time awaits you. Your wishes could manifest right before your eyes. This is an amazing reading, Natalie. This is amazing. Just understand that there's going to be people around you who are going to be jealous with whatever this is coming in towards you. It could be a really good, solid relationship. It could be a really good, solid contract. Whatever this is to you, or what, however you're reading it, be mindful of what you tell people. Don't tell people all of your business, okay? Hey, Big Mike. Hey there. You paid for a reading? Okay. I hope that that helped, Natalie, and I hope that it gave you some clarity on what's coming towards you. So don't give up, because there's a lot of good things coming towards you, okay? Aw, thank you, Angela Denise. You're so sweet. Rashida. I'm going to go and pick over. Thank you for the gift. You're welcome.
Okay.
you so much, Dora. I really appreciate that. Yep, I think I have 4 more spots left. How many spots we got left? Is Nikki still in here? She may have gone out. I think I got 4 spots left, actually, for readings. 4 spots. Thanks, Nikki. Rashida, where you at, honey? Oh, thank you for the gifts, you guys. All right. Rashida, did you want general, love, financial, health? Thank you so much, Natalie, for becoming a subscriber. I need you guys to email me if you're becoming a subscriber, because I can't DM you because they have me banned from DMing people. So they have me shadow banned, you guys. So email me. The link is in the bio so that I can send you the information on how to get to the private group, okay? You want love and finance? I can mix that. I can mix that in a little bit. You pay for a 7-card spread? Okay. Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit, for Rashida when it comes to love and finances. Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit, when it comes to love and finances for Rashida. Show me what I need to see and not what I want to see. We ask that you protect us while we receive. Oh, there's an emperor about to come up in towards you now, Rashida. Aries energy. We got the Fool, so they may want you to take a trust fall with them. Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit. But I also feel like there's someone in the background that you know is feeling left out by you. Show me what I need to see for Rashida for love and finances. What do I need to see? For love and finances for Rashida. Bottom of the deck is the Chariot. You're moving forward with something. Cancer, ooh, there's a lot of emotion. The Moon, the 9 of Wands. I feel like there's someone in their feelings in the background, Rashida. And I feel like you're guarded against this person. Like you're guarding your emotions against this person. I feel like you may have called judgment on some type of relationship with them, or maybe you're unhappy with this person. Show me what I need to see for Rashida. Please, you know, however it sounds like it's coming to you, take it that way. We got Page of Wands. So there's some type of a message coming in here. The King of Pentacles. So there could be a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn, or an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius about to reach out to you. What do I need to see for Rashida? When it comes to love and finances, this could be a job, or this could be something that you guys, the Ace of Swords and the High Priestess. This could be a job that's about to send you some type of communication to give you some clarity. And I feel like you may know this, or this could be a few people getting ready to come towards you. We got the Knight of Cups on the bottom of the deck. So there's someone coming in here that wants to take you out. You could be getting some type of message from them. I don't feel like this person is someone new. There is someone new, but no, not this other person who's going to be sending you the message. I feel like they've been overanalyzing some type of situation with you, and they're about to reach out to you and tell you that they want to take you out, okay? But I feel like you already know that there's some type of a message coming in. We got the Three of Wands. Yeah, you've been waiting for something. What else for? Yeah, maybe an apology from someone. Could be from someone in your family here. I don't know why Spirit is bringing this out, but I'm just going to read along with what Spirit's bringing out. We got the Four of Swords. Yeah, the Sun. There's someone who wants to heal something here with you, and it could be a family member or someone that you saw as family. Now, this person doesn't seem like they know exactly what they want to say to you with the Page of Pentacles here and the Three of Wands. Like, they're waiting and they're trying to figure out what they want to say to you or how they're supposed to approach a situation. But they do want to heal something here with you, because when the Sun and the Four of Swords comes out together, that's like somebody really, really wanting to heal something here with you. And you're going to see it. Like, you're going to see that they want to do that. Okay? Your finances look like they're going to be okay. Show me what I need to see for Tashi. What does Tashi need to see for love and finances? They already, look, luck just flipped over. So you're about to get a streak of luck coming in here. Whatever this is, you're about to get it. And I feel like it has something to do with your money, with the King of Pentacles here. It could also be a boss getting ready to send you some type of information. So luck, a sudden change of luck is likely. Things are working in your favor. Excellent time for networking. So you got to get yourself out there and network. If you're looking for a job or you're looking for something that you want to do, that you like to do, you got to put yourself out there. Oh, and we got romance. I can't make it up. Love is set to sizzle. The chance for romance is high for those seeking a connection. Someone is definitely coming out. A few people are coming in. Bottom of the deck is assert yourself. Go for what you want. The time is ripe. I'm telling you, go for what you want, because the time is definitely ripe right now. Like, you're wide open. I don't know if you're putting in applications. I don't know if what you're doing in the background, but there's someone who's going to be reaching out to you with some type of an offer here. And watch how much you're working, because I do see burnout back there. I see burnout. So that means that you're not resting. You need some healing. You need to rest. You're working too much. Okay. Hey, how are you? Wow, he asked me 5 minutes ago. Wow. All right. I hope that that helped you, Rashida. I definitely feel like if you're looking for another job, there's going to be something coming in here for you. But your love life is about to go up, too. I feel like there's going to be people coming in to ask you to go out that you don't expect, okay? I feel like one of them you already know is tripping in the background, but, you know, it seems like they lost their chance. Hey, Macy, how are you? I hope that it gave you insight, and I hope it brought you clarity. You're welcome. All right, I don't see any more paid readings, so you guys, I'm going to get off of here. Thank you guys for supporting me and coming in to hear the collective and to, oh wait, I do see one. Kiana, oh, there you are. You're welcome, love. And did you want general love, financial, spiritual? Love, okay. I'm gonna give you a few of these for the love, and then I'm going to also pull the tarot and see what spirit says about future love energy. Show me what I need to see, please, spirit, for Kiana when it comes to love. Now, spirit's probably going to show me past stuff that you've been through or present stuff that you're going through, and also future. I never know how spirit's going to show me, so show me what I need to see for Kiana when it comes to love. What does Kiana need to know about love? Show me what I need to see for Kiana. Show me what I need to see. We got boat and engagement ring. Oh. Kiana, somebody gonna take you on a trip and ask you to marry them? Show me what I need to see for Kiana. For love. Bottom of the deck is love call. You're about to get an invitation or something like this. Someone letting you know that they're missing you. Show me what I need to see for Kiana when it comes to love. We got passion. Oh, shit. I like it. insane chemistry, like each other equally, having fun, healthy choices. So whoever this is, you done made a healthy choice, baby. Okay, show me more for Kiana. And you also choosing yourself, self-love, self-care, being happier. I love it. Ooh, we got karmic relationships. So you could have been in a karmic relationship and now you're making healthier choices. What else? What else for Kiana? You got the butterfly. You're going through some type of a transformation here. Bottom of the deck is talking. So you could definitely be getting ready to talk with someone. We got interested, conversing more, awaited messages, arrives, emails. We got not today, not dealing hurt, avoid conversation, call or person, boundary, still angry. I feel like that's that karmic relationship there. Okay, yeah, stabbed in the back. That's definitely that karmic relationship. And we got the butterfly, relationship evolving to the next level and healing the inner child. So you are healing your inner child at this time. And I feel like it's bringing this love in. Let me see what's behind there. We got love call, boat, engagement ring, ascending. I feel like your relationship's about to go to a whole nother level. You're getting a divorce. All right. Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit, for Kiana. For love. For the future. What's coming in the future for Kiana for love? Future energy, Kiana. Look, Ten of Cups, Queen of Pentacles. Your money's about to go up. And I don't know if you're a mother, but you could be. But your money's about to go up. And look at your family, all happy. Emotional fulfillment there. Show me what I need to see for Kiana, for love. Near future. Kiana for love. Nine of Pentacles. Okay. You are single right now. You could be... Oh. You could be assessing someone or someone could be assessing you. They're about to come in and give you an offer here. Knight of Cups. Show me what I need to see for Kiana. Near future love. One. Thank you. Look at you. Look at you. Okay. We got the Empress and the Three of Pentacles. Definitely feel like a situation is going to be really, really good for you. It's going to be very prosperous, too. I feel like you guys are going to be like a power couple or something like this here. Okay. Bottom of the deck is the Three of Wands. I feel like you're waiting for this. It's coming. You're manifesting. It's coming. Hierophant, the Page of Cups. There's an offer coming in. Okay. I think I have two more spots. It's okay, Angela. You're welcome, Kiana. I hope that it gave you some insight, okay? And I hope that it gave you clarity on whatever you wanted clarity on. Thank you, Nikki, for hanging in here with me. I appreciate you. We got to get together so I can tell you about your benefits. You just paid for one? Abigail Borja? Is that how you say it? Abigail, okay. Did you want, I'll do yours next. Let me see. I'll do yours next, C. Abigail? Oh, let me do Sierra's first, if you don't mind. And because she got a three-card spread. Okay? And then I'll do yours, Abigail, because you got a mini read. Okay? Thank you. I appreciate it. All right, C. Come into the sweetie spirit for CT. Did you want love, general, financial? You may have told me in the daggone text. I didn't see it. No. I'm good. How are you? Thank you so much for your compliment. You want love. Okay. Come into the sweetie spirit for CC. And show me what I need to see for CC for love. Show me what I need to see and not what I want to see. We ask that you protect us while we receive these messages, and we thank you for your spirit. Bottom of the deck is love call. So somebody could be reaching out to you, CC, to let you know that they love you. Show me what I need to see. Whoa. For CC. We got healthy choices. So you're making healthy choices this time. That's good. What else for C? Give me a few. Bottom of the deck is stabbed in the back. Yeah, I feel like that's that past relationship. We got hand of cards, healthy choices, dragonfly, and talking. So you could be talking to someone right now, kind of like seeing if you're interested, or maybe you are interested, or they're interested, and you could be talking to someone right now. We got passion, the butterfly, self-indulgence, feel like you're doing self-love. I feel like you were in a karmic relationship, but there is someone that likes you here. There is someone that likes you a lot. I feel like they may be in love with you. Show me what I need to see for CC for, we'll do the fortune cookie for you, CC. Show me what I need to see for CC for love, or whatever you have to tell her, spirit. What does CC need to know? I do feel like you're making healthier choices now. I feel like you're putting a lot of energy into you. There could be someone that you're talking to. Show me what I need to see for CC for love. We got luck. One more. We got commitment falling out. So there's some type of a commitment that's going to be brought to you. Someone wants to commit to you. A commitment is indicated around love or business. It will make you feel better. And then we have luck. A sudden change of luck is likely. Things are working in your favor. Great time to network. So definitely feel like there's a new love coming in towards you. Bottom of the deck is opportunities. A stranger is about to change your life. Exciting times and plenty of action, plus a special family reunion looks likely. It looks like you're about to meet a twin flame. A real one, not the one that you were in. You were in a karmic relationship, okay? But this is going to be real. All right, see. 11-11. All right, Abigail. Did you want general, love, financial? I mean, since you got a mini, everything's probably going to come out. Everything that you're dealing with is going to come out. You're welcome. Okay, you want a general. Okay, we can do a general. Come into this reading, spirit, for Abigail. And show me what I need to see, please, spirit, for Abigail. Show me what I need to see, please, spirit, for Abigail. Nope, you would be the next person. I'm sorry, I'm fucking up your name. Show me whatever I need to see. And I think you get the last spot, actually. Show me what I need to see, please, spirit, for Abigail. What do I need to see for Abigail? What's going on with Abigail? Show me what I need to see for Abigail. We got the Wheel of Fortune and the King of Pentacles. Oh, Abigail, looks like your money's about to go up. Or you could be dealing with a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. That something's about to shift in that. We got the World and the King of Pentacles. I feel like this is your money about to go up. I don't know if you're doing something online here to have passive income or something, but that's what it feels like to me. Show me what, or maybe you're going to. Show me what I need to see for Abigail. I feel like you're very guarded against someone who may have juggled you. Bottom of the deck is the Nine of Wands. You could be tired of something. I feel like you're either tired of something or someone wants to reconnect with you. Okay, you're going to be getting some type of communication from this person. I feel like they did juggle you, Abigail. Okay. with this judgment here, yeah, I feel like this person broke your heart. And it could have been a Virgo, Taurus, or a Capricorn. This could definitely have been a higher level of commitment. Show me what I need to see for Abigail. For what does Abigail need to know, Spirit? Show me what I need to see for Abigail. We got the Nine of Cups coming out. Whoa. We got the Nine of Cups coming out and the King of Cups. I feel like somebody is very selfish here. They're all about their own. We got the Queen of Swords, and it did flip into the reverse. So I don't know if you're dealing with a bitch or somebody else is dealing with a bitch, but somebody's mouth is off the hook and they're a liar. We got the World coming out. I definitely feel like you're trying to start something new on your own here. We got the Tower. Wow. I feel like there's going to be an all of a sudden in this new cycle here. You could be dealing with a Scorpio or a water sign. Doesn't have to be. Also Taurus, Leo, Aquarius. What else? We got the Two of Swords. There's some type of a decision that I feel like you're going to have to make. Or there's going to be a Tower moment. You could have already had this Tower moment. We got the Six of Pentacles. Something about something being equal. Maybe something is not so equal. And I feel like Spirit is giving you a chance to correct it. Or the Tower's coming. It may have already came, is what I'm saying. Okay, I don't know what's going on. These numbers are driving me crazy. Oh, Lord. What else for Abigail? I'm going to clarify that Tower because I want to know what that is. We got the Queen of Cups and the Three of Pentacles coming out here. Three of Pentacles. Somebody wants to work with you on something. It's a King of Cups. I don't know if you were married to this person or if you have a long-term relationship with them, but they want to start something new here with you. I feel like this S is going to come out of nowhere. Like, I don't even know if you're talking to this person. Ooh, we got the Ten of Cups and it jumped into the reverse. So I don't know if you're unhappy in some type of a situation that you're in. We got the Ten of Pentacles though. So I don't know. This seems like, I don't know if you're going back and forth on a decision with someone, but you need to make a decision. Okay, you're going to be getting some type of communication coming in here. Probably from an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, or a Scorpio. You could be dealing with a water sign, or you could be a water sign. There is something hidden from you about an ending. You're going to get communication about something ending here, something that you're not aware of. And it could have something to do with family, but I feel like it has something to do with money as well. Somebody definitely wants to reconcile with you. All right, let's do some clarification here. Why is this Nine of Cups here? What's this Nine of Cups? Why is this Nine of Cups here? I'm dealing with a Scorpio. What is this? Thank you. We got the Strength and the Eight of Cups coming out. Yeah, I feel like you're walking away from someone or something here. Because I don't feel like you have the patience for it anymore. Either you or someone else doesn't have the patience for something anymore. Like someone's tired of somebody being selfish or something like this here. What is this King of Cups? The Ace of Swords. So you could be getting some type of truth from someone or a type of clarity from someone. Maybe they don't usually give you clarity, or maybe you're getting clarity without them even giving you clarity. Like you're receiving it yourself. What is this Queen of Swords? Thank you. The Eight of Pentacles. I feel like this could have something to do with work. I don't know if you, Justice and the King of Swords, this could have something to do with work. You could be dealing with a bitch at work or someone who lies at work. Or something like this here. And I feel like you're tired of it. You got the clarity on it. Or something like this. It has something to do with family as well. What is this World? But I feel work. What is this World here? Yeah, the Judgment, the Three of Swords. I feel like whatever cycle this is that you've been going in with this person, you've been getting your heart broke. Like, you've been disappointed over and over again or something, and you're guarded. Nine of Wands on the bottom of the deck. We got Scorpio energy here as the Tower. So, what is this Tower? This is some type of a major change here that you need to make some type of a decision on. What is this Tower? Oh, the Ace of Cups. So, whoever this Scorpio is, they could be giving you clarity that they want to come together with you, Abigail. And it could shock you either the way that they're going to bring this in, but they're going to bring you in clarity that they want to be with you, okay? Ace of Swords and the Ace of Cups, they're going to give you clarity that they want to be with you, Ace of Cups, okay? What is this Two of Swords if they haven't already? What's this Two of Swords? Or you could be giving them clarity. What is this Two of Swords? Like, someone's already made up their mind here. The Five of Cups, the Emperor, the Four of Cups. Yeah. It's like with this decision, Two of Swords in reverse, it's like you decided, I'm coming out of feeling sad. I'm tired of feeling sad. I'm tired of feeling sad. You're taking control of this. I feel like you could also be looking at other offers, or there could be other offers coming towards you. I feel like you're kind of tired of looking at spilled milk. Like, you're tired of looking at what already happened. I feel like you keep doing that, but you, I don't know if you can help it or not. Two of Cups is on the bottom of the deck. There's a lot of love here. There's a lot of love here. I feel like somebody could be a little controlling. What is this Queen of Cups? What is this Queen of Cups? Or domineering. They could have tattoos or a sleeve of tattoo. You could have that. What is this Queen of Cups? What's this Queen of Cups? The Ace of Wands and the King of Pentacles. There's some offers coming in here. This could definitely be work, like I said. There could also be love coming in for you. It's like you're going to be getting some type of clarity when it comes to work, what you need to walk away from. I feel like you're tired of having your heart broken and you're calling judgment on a cycle with someone. But someone's going to come in here with a love offer. We got three. We got the Ace of Wands, the Ace of Cups, and the Ace of Swords. And they're all in the upright. You're about to have like three new beginnings here. If you decide. Remember, this is just energy. Energy changes on the different actions that you take. So, Ace of Wands, King of Pentacles, there's some type of a passionate offer here from someone, and this person could be very well off, okay? Knight of Wands on the bottom of the deck. Three of Pentacles. It could be a work situation. What's this Three of Pentacles? We got the Page of Swords. Someone watches how you work with other people. We got the Star. And the Page of Wands, you're about to get some type of an offer here. Another offer. Wow. We got the Queen of Pentacles. So there you are coming up as the match to this King of Pentacles. We got the Queen of Wands, the Sun. You could have found out that somebody was with somebody else. Could be a mother of their children or anybody else. I feel like people are starting to recognize you for what you bring to the table. Someone is assessing some type of situation with you, and I feel like it's a love situation. Someone's coming in with an offer. We got the Ace of Pentacles. That was the last ace. Someone's coming in with an offer. Someone sees you as a star. What is this Ten of Cups? What's this Ten of Cups? Someone's trying to see if they can work with you on something. High Priestess. Pisces energy. Like, you're going to be so happy with this offer that comes in here towards you. I don't feel like this is an old offer. I feel like this is new. Hangman, yeah, it's going to have you in your head. Chariot and the Lovers. Wow. All major arcana on the bottom of the deck. I definitely feel like this is a soulmate coming in towards you here that you're really going to be happy with. You're going to be able to lay down some burdens with this person. Like, this person is going to be your equal, okay? Definitely feel like there could be work attached to it. I don't know why, but I do. There's a lot of pentacles here and a lot of offers. All right? I hope that that worked for you, and I hope that it gave you the insight that you needed and the clarity that you needed. There's a lot going on for you this month, I hear. I feel like some are going to be surprises for you, but there's a lot going on for you this month, okay? All right. Give me 1 second. And then, you're very welcome. Give me a second, you guys. Let me see if anybody else. A and B J's bundles. Who is this? Okay, thank you, Nikki. Bree. See, Bree. Can I just call you Bree? Okay, thank you. Did you want general love, financial, spiritual? All right. Come into this reading, spirit, for Bree. And show me what I need to see for Bree. Sorry, somebody's mowing their lawn. Show me what I need to see, so I hope y'all can still hear me good. Show me what I need to see, please, spirit, for Bree. Show me what I need to see and not what I want to see. We ask that you protect us while we receive these messages. And we thank you, Spirit. I just saw the Six of Swords, so I believe you're moving to calmer waters at this time. You could be very guarded. Okay? Like you ain't playing. But there's something coming towards you that you don't see with the moon. Yeah, there's some type of an ending or something like this here. Some type of a transformation with a lot of emotion. Show me what I need to see. Somebody could be watching you go through this transformation that you're going through, too. You could be dealing with a Scorpio or an Aquarius, Libra, or Gemini. Show me what I need to see for Brie. Yeah, someone's watching you go through a transformation. They see you being an empress. Show me what I need to see for Brie. Bottom of the deck is the Page of Swords. So someone is watching you. Someone is watching the Empress come into play. The Fool. Wow. Something new for you coming in here. The Wheel of Fortune and the King of Pentacles. Girl. And the Knight of Cups. There's a few people coming in here towards you. Okay. And the King, Queen of Wands. Okay. Let me say this. Mercury retrograde starts on the 21st, but it always starts before then. Okay. So there could be people coming back from the past. But a few of these look new. Now, also, there's going to be people, because Saturn is in play, there's going to be people having to deal with karma. And so these people that are dealing with karma who did you dirty, they could be coming back towards you, too, to ask for forgiveness. Show me what I need to, because of Saturn. Show me what I need to see for Brie. What do I need to see for Brie? But someone wants to romance you. I just saw the Knight of Cups. So someone wants to give you some romance. We got the World coming out. So you starting a whole new cycle here. New chapter. World. And the Eight of Cups. Oh, you walking away from something. Maybe from jealous folks. Five of Swords. Girl, they already cycling back. I don't want it. I know that's right. What else? The Eight of Pentacles. You're focused on work here, but I feel like people are jealous of what you do for work. What do you do for work? Two of Pentacles here, and I feel like you're also juggling. But you're about to get some You're about to come into some good money. Yes, Nine of Cups is going to make you really happy here. You're going towards what you want, but you're juggling something. I don't know if you're doing two different things, two different businesses, two different whatever. But whatever, you got a new cycle coming in here. Like, you walking away from people who are jealous and all up in your business and trying to make things bad for you. What is that? We got the Fool, something brand new, baby. The Fool coming out. Queen of Wands. Oh. I definitely feel like this has something to do with the creative outlet. But there's someone in the background that feels left out by you, and they watching you, okay? It could be an Aries. Doesn't have to be. Could be a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn, or a Libra as well. I get to travel, but I want to get back into music and podcasts and Airbnb. Okay. Sounds nice. What else? We got the King of Swords coming out here. There's some type of a head-over-heart decision you're going to be making. And we got the Queen of Pentacles. This is something new with your business, girl. Yes, sun on the bottom of the deck. Whatever this is, Queen of Pentacles, your money's going to be set. Okay? Whatever direction you decide to go into, just be careful what you're telling people. Don't, because there's people back here that's jealous. Okay? But I feel like you're just going for what you want. Watch what you tell people about the moves that you're making. Why is this Fool here? What's this Fool? The Nine of Wands. So you're standing up for this new beginning that you're trying to have here. Whatever this Fool is with your businesses that you're trying to make happen, you're like, I'm doing this. Look, clarity, Ace of Swords, and the Sun. Wow. You're going to get the clarity you need. If you're not really sure about how to do it or which way to go or how to start back to what you want to do, you're definitely going through some transformation because there's a butterfly, a big-ass pink butterfly up above this King of Swords. And I feel like this is the way that you're thinking now has transformed. I don't think you think the same way anymore. There's something that you've gone through that has changed the way that you think about things, especially when it comes to business, when it comes to your money. Something new is coming in here for you, and you're guarding it with your life. I like that. What is this Eight of Pentacles? Wow. The King of Cups, the Ten of Cups, and the King of Wands. There's something about your work that you're so passionate about. I feel like you definitely are going for it, and it's going to make you happy. You're an entrepreneur. This is giving me entrepreneur vibes, okay? You're going to be really happy in your work when you switch it over. When you go back to what you're doing, I feel like you're really going to be in charge and you're going to really be happy with what you're doing. You're going to have the clarity that you need. The Ace of Swords is on the bottom of the deck. You're going to have the clarity that you need. I also feel like you're going to get the clarity that someone wants to come back towards you, okay? I don't know if you used to work with this person or what. What is this Nine of Cups here? We got the Knight of Cups, also the Seven of Wands. I feel like you are so guarded against this. Whoever this is trying to come in here to romance you, probably from the past, okay? You're so guarded because you feel like this person is selfish. Whoever this is, they must think that they the man. Look at him sitting up there. You're very guarded. You're very, very guarded, okay? Why is the world here? Why is this world here? Why is this world here? What's this world? The Knight of Pentacles. So, this new cycle for you is going to be very steady, very grounded. Your money is about to go up. Like, we got all these pentacles here. Because you think of things differently. You're not seeing things the same way as you used to. I don't know if you feel like you do, but you don't. That's not what these cards say. You're assessing things differently. Why is this Eight of Cups here? And I'm going to pull you a fortune cookie. Why is this Eight of Cups here? That's too many. We got the Emperor. So you could have walked away from Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, or someone who was trying to dominate you. Show me what I need to see for these Eight of Cups. What's this Eight of Cups? One card, please. Eight of Cups. Thank you. That's not one, but thank you. We got the Queen of Cups and the Star. Yeah, you're walking away to go towards what you want. I definitely feel like you're not going to be giving your cup up that easily to anyone. Because you see yourself with some type of a celebrity type future here. So I don't feel like you're focused on giving your cup away to anyone. Her cup has a lid on it. And you're focused on who will I want to give it to. I definitely feel like there's people in your background that are jealous of what's going on with you because they're making up stories because you're not telling them anything. I don't know who that could be. But you have kings in your energy. King of Cups, King of Wands. You also have the Knight of Pentacles. So there's a few. And the Knight of Cups. Also the King of Swords. So there's quite a few people around you. All right, my love. Let me give you a fortune cookie. Show me what I need to see, please, for Bree for near future. What does Bree have to look forward to for the near future, please, Spirit? Future for Bree, near future. Good. Aw, thank you, Belle. Show me what I need to see for Brie. What do I need to see for Brie? Yeah, that's what it looks like. You're focused on work, and that's going to bring you in a lot of money. All right, Brie. We got twists and turns. Carefully made plans could be thrown out the window as major changes and interruptions surround you. Make sure you get lots of rest to cope with the upheaval. So there, you could have already been going through this. Or this is something that's coming soon, okay? We also got difficult times. Be on your guard against chaos as unforeseen or emotional upheaval is foretold. So definitely feel like there could be some people trying to start some shit, okay? And then we got sexuality. Existing relationships could find a new passion and heightened sexual attraction. Opportunities for marriage and good family life are strong. But if single, beware of temptation that could lead to trouble. A child will also bring great joy. So I don't know if you're getting ready to have a child or someone around you is. We have sunshine. The sun is shining on you. Career and business growth. Fabulous communication and relationships. I can't bring it up. I mean, make it up. You know, you're going to have really good, when you go towards whatever you're switching over to, it's going to really fly up for you. We got jealousy. I can't make it up. Someone around you is jealous of you, okay? Watch out. Watch who you trust with your personal secrets and plans. Spend time outdoors in nature to reconnect. And then we got romance. So someone is going to try to come in and romance you, but someone definitely is jealous of you. I felt that, okay? Absolutely. Absolutely, Bray. All right, you guys. I love y'all. Thank y'all for supporting me. And thank you for coming in. And for all my newbies, love you. Please, please come back. I'm probably be on to tonight. I don't know what time I have clients for my coaching business. But I will be back on. I'm going to try to be back on around 7 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. Okay, y'all? I love y'all. And I hope that y'all have a good day. You're welcome, Max Stacy. I read you seamlessly. Wow, that ain't nothing but spirit. That ain't nothing but spirit. All right, my love. Bye, y'all.